do all hot topics, and here with the inside scoop is our entertainment journalist friend, Chris Witherspoon. Chris.
Thank you, such an honor to be here today. And Wendy, can I just say, you guys, this is so much more than a daytime talk show. It is a pop culture movement, and it is great to have our queen back on her throne, where she belongs,
Hollywood.
Thank you, Chris. Okay. Chris covers it like nobody does. Michael Jackson last night, I watched.
Yes, so there was a two-part special. Part one aired last night on HBO. Mm-hmm. It's called Leaving Neverland. Part two airs tonight. And we meet two men, James Safechuck and Wade Robson, who met Michael Jackson when they were young. Now they're all grown up and alleging that Michael Jackson sexually assaulted them. We have a clip from the documentary. We'll show that really fast, and I'll tell you more.
Okay.
There's no thoughts of this is wrong or anything like that.
He told me if they ever found out what we were doing, he and I would go to jail for the rest of our lives.
Secrets will eat you up. You feel so alone.
I want to be able to speak the truth as loud as I had to speak the lie for so long.
Okay, so this is powerful. It was hard to watch. I watched it last night. Very strong allegations. They talk about how they met Michael Jackson, how he befriended them, came like a part of their family, like a family friend.
The families welcomed them into the house.
Yes. So. And then the sexual abuse started. But we start with Jimmy Safechuck, who's behind us right now. We see him.
Which color shirt?
That's Jimmy Safechuck right there, the black shirt. Okay. He met Michael Jackson when he was 10 years old. He shot a Pepsi commercial for him with 1987. Mm-hmm. And Michael Jackson invited him to go on tour, the Bad Tour. And during the Bad Tour, he was staying in hotel rooms with Michael Jackson, and that's when the abuse starts. So Jimmy's a legend, you guys. Hold somebody's hand because it gets very serious. Jimmy's a legend that Michael Jackson began to teach him how to masturbate. He also masturbated in front of him. He French kissed with him. Jimmy said that Michael said this was a first person.
I don't believe a word of anything in this documentary.
Okay, Wendy.
I'll tell you in a second. No, continue, because, you know, Michael's no innocent, but...
Yes.
I'm curious to get
your opinion on this. Yes, but Jimmy also alleges that Michael would, like, run drills with him so he can get dressed really fast in the hotel room in case someone came knocking at the door. There was also a makeshift wedding. He pulls out this box of jewelry, and that's the part that I sort of believed. He's holding this ring and talks about how one day in the hotel room, Michael had a makeshift wedding where they exchanged vows and put down like little vows on paper and said they're gonna be together forever.
Yeah.
Also another guy in the documentary, Wade Robson. You guys might recall him. He like did choreography for NSYNC and Britney Spears at one point. He was 5 years old when he met Michael Jackson. In Australia, he won a dance contest and got to travel with Michael Jackson and be on stage with him in Australia. But after that, 2 years later.
Now, were the parents traveling with Michael and the boys?
Yes, they were.
Most of the time they were.
But 2 years later, the parents and the boy and Wade come to Neverland Ranch, and that is when Wade's alleging the abuse started.
Uh-huh.
So Wade says that 7 years old, Michael Jackson was performing oral sex on him, and they were taking showers together in the nude.
Lies.
You think it's all false, Wendy?
I do believe a shower in the nude. I don't believe that there was any sexual touching. I do believe sleepovers in the same bed. I do believe that if Mother Nature takes its course and you get a hard penis, I don't believe touching and I don't believe sex. And I do believe that this is a money grab for the families.
Come on.
This is what I believe. I believe.
Yeah.
And I've been around long enough, I believe that Joe Jackson, rest in peace, he did the best that he could in raising this showbiz family. Michael became the star of the family, and even though he had all those siblings, he was still trapped in being Michael, in Michael world.
Yeah.
You know, sequestered off into his part of the house and doing his thing, watching old movies, I believe that part. Mrs. Jackson, you know, she's not well, she doesn't need to hear this. Mm-hmm. And you know,
what are Michael Jackson's kids? They don't want to hear this either.
Michael Jackson's kids, they're not so well.
They're not so well either. Yeah.
At all. But I don't believe any of this. I do believe that this is money for the families. And I do believe that Michael was having a problem with drugs. Well, who wouldn't? When you're doing your own dancing, think about it. If you're dancing from the time you're 3 years old, you know what I mean? And dancing hard.
Yes.
And then, ow, your back hurts. And then you get the dosed up. By the time you're 15 years old, the doses are three times as much. By the time you're 25 years old, the doses are five times as much, and you're free to take them as much as you want. Then you get these fancy doctors. These fancy doctors who will come to your house 3 o'clock in the morning, 5 o'clock in the morning.
Give you whatever you want.
Or take a wing at your house and wheel in those fancy machines and you know, intravenous exactly, you
yes, yeah.
and
put
pop
you, to sleep,
you with
wake
pills.
You up, all of it.
They kept him doped up. That's what I believe.
Okay, okay, Wendy. I think that there's a lot of reasoning to that, and I think that Michael.
What do you think?
You know, I'm still torn.
I you think believe that, it.
Can I tell you? I don't necessarily believe all of it, but I think that there were parts that were done so well, like even the mothers being involved. I was always curious to hear from the moms because I have a 7-year-old son, and there is no Beyonce could call tomorrow. My son is not going away with anybody without me being in the room with him. You know, and I love Beyonce. She is my Michael Jackson, but I would never leave the room. I'd say, oh, where are we going together?
Now, if my fiance wants to have a sleepover with your son.
God, no, I would be in the room. Where are we sleeping? I'll be sleeping right next to them on the bed together. But I think it was powerful to hear from the moms. I thought that Wade's mom coming out and talking about how Michael was really a part of the family was really compelling because it kind of made me understand how he really endeared himself into the core of the family.
Not me. It made me understand that Michael never had a childhood and so vacuuming and doing regular things, eating Cheerios with his hands. That, the stuff that we take for granted as regular kids, he didn't have. Now, the Jackson
But at 31 years old, having a sleepover with a 7-year-old, that felt a little odd to me. It felt a little odd.
It is a little odd, but he was never able to be seven. When Michael was seven, Michael was like 17. The things he had to do and his responsibilities.
Okay.
The Jackson family spoke out.
Yes.
Take a look at this.
Does the whole family feel this way? I've seen the comments from the brothers, but I haven't heard anything from your sisters.
Everybody feels the same way about this.
Of course.
I think there's a fear as well to put more energy to it and more eyeballs to it. I think that's why my Aunt Janet hasn't said anything, because she doesn't want to make it any bigger.
Why do you think they're coming forward now?
Money.
You think it's all about money?
Well, it's all about money.
It's always been about money. I hate to say it, when it's my uncle, it's almost like they see a blank check.
So that was Tito's son, Taj, also Jackie.
He was a little pudgy there,
yes,
right?
Yes, he actually stayed at Neverland Ranch. He actually stayed at Neverland for a little while.
Yes.
Yeah, he's probably been eating a little bit. But yes, but the Jackson family filed a $100 million lawsuit against the estate. But it's important to against HBO. But it's important to note that these two guys did not get paid from HBO for this documentary.
And HBO did not get the sanction of the Jackson family to run this?
Yeah, so they did not go and talk to the director, Dan Reed, did not speak to the Jackson, which also makes it very one-sided, and I do have a problem with that.
I have a problem that I actually want to engage in part two tonight, because I don't believe this. I am going to be watching with a low-fat snack.
Yes, yes, yes.
Thank you, Chris Witherspoon.
Yes,
Oprah's interview afterwards.
Yes, yes.
Chris Witherspoon, everybody, for more information on this story, go to wendyshow.com.